What is it, Buck Survivors? This is Lucy.
And this is Alcarin. Bringing you that sweet, sweet new commentary. What are we trying to do today there, guys?
We're doing a tour of my base.
Another base tour episode. Do you think it'll be as good or at least as Wrath Clan, you think?
Pretty epic.
Pretty epic. Did you build this whole thing on your own?
Yep. Just me and my tribe. Nobody else. Haven't found anyone.
No, so are you planning to invite more people as time goes on?
If I can find someone that's not, like, weird or anything. I'm very picky.
Yeah, gotcha. I think almost on all our servers, you've always been by yourself. Only one time did you actually take somebody in, right?
Yeah. Then we were with, and then I was with Mighty for a little bit.
Yeah, how was that?
Oh, that's right.
That was fun.
All right, let's get the show on the road.
All right, here we go.
So we're in the center on the brand new DLC center map. And we're running the Primitive Plus mod. And this is an open server available to anybody that wants to join.
So my outer defense is on the center here, this region called the center. There's all these pillars, and I've got plant turrets on all of them.
I see that. And what's the point of the all these metal pillars?
It keeps people from barrel rolling pteranodons through it and gotcha. From building on it. And it's metal, which normally you can't learn the metal engrams on Primitive Plus, but you can get them from drops. And the only thing that can break these are cannons.
Gotcha. So it's kind of cool that, you know, it's not available to everybody, but if you get lucky in a drop and a blueprint, those are extremely valuable, probably the most valuable things in the game.
Yep. I have half of a metal dino gate. I need to find the other half.
I personally have found a metal door for a while, and then I found the metal door frame. But I've never... And then they took the metal door out, I think. So I have the two that I placed, but I don't have the blueprint anymore.
Yep, so here's the main base.
Woo! This is amazing! And you got the water and everything.
Yep. I was like, oh yeah, I'm gonna build a base, like, straddling the water. And with, like, the dino gate, so it just looks really cool.
So defensively, this is rock solid.
Mm-hmm. Got all the plant turrets going on. And I've built these outer walls here that you can walk through.
Now, for our viewers who don't play on Primitive Plus, maybe explain the brick and the concrete, just because not a lot of people play on these servers. They don't understand.
Right. So the brick and the concrete is the highest building tier of the game that's available. And to make it, you make it with cement, which you make in a cement mixer from limestone and cementing paste. And it's very—it's actually very efficient and cheap to make. So it's not too bad. Once you're established, you can churn out a lot of it. And then the brick is made with cement and bricks, which you make in first you got to make clay out of claystone and limestone in a handmill. And then you can... And then you get clay buckets, which you then cook in a furnace. And then you can get the bricks from that and then use it to build the walls and stuff.
Where are you, Bob? We lost you.
I'm up here.
You're up there.
Top.
Okay. How'd you get up there?
There's a ladder, like, right in front of the door.
Okay, cool.
Is that pretty much you have this so that if people try to siege you from the sides, you go in there and you have coverage and you can shoot at them?
Yeah, basically, I've got windows and stuff I can shoot out of. I got these walls up here, and it's actually also to kind of protect the inside of the base from cannons so that they can't just snipe all of the stuff that's inside from outside without first breaking through this. And it keeps my dinos from wandering off the edge sometimes.
Now, about how long did all this take to build? Like, because this is a 15x server, so the gather rates are a little bit cranked. So how long would you say it took you to get all this established?
It probably took me about 15-20 hours, so not too bad.
It's not too bad. Also, a cannon on this server, I think they do accelerated damage.
They do because they're a ranged weapon, and ranged weapons have their damage increased.
Now, is that a good thing or a bad thing?
Yeah, well, it makes cannons a little more effective than they ordinarily are. The ammunition is still expensive. It's not prohibitively so you can still, like, churn out a bunch of it, but it's not, like, trivial.
Gotcha.
With these buildings, because stone and brick don't mesh quite right, so the only way to get into the doors is to crouch. Like, first I built these out of stone, and then I added the brick, and the brick layered all on the inside.
Ooh, this is nice. Is this your crank it out area where you just...
Yeah, this was my first beginning area. This is just where I churned everything out. You got smith, you got your blacksmith table or smithy, and then you got your construction table, cement mixer, beds, and then the useless grindstone. Sad.
Until they fix it, then we'll be able to make battle axes, right?
Yes, until they fix it.
And battle axes, is that a primitive plus only thing, or is that part of the base game?
Yeah, it's a primitive plus only thing.
Gotcha. Lucy, do you have any questions for Bob?
Nope, just watching and looking. It's got a lot.
There's a lot to take in, huh?
I know.
And then in here, this is where I keep my beetles.
How many beetles are you running?
I just got two.
Lucy first?
I need to get
more. What is this no fapping?
So that's like an inside joke from the very first server I ever played on. I had a tribe of about five people, and then one of the guys, it was just a vanilla server. Gather rates were just like three times. And so one of our guys was dedicated to farming, and he had the one building where he had all of the compost bins, and he called it the Duke Cut, and he had the no fapping sign. So it was funny. I'm not sure exactly why it was funny, but
and what is this fapping that you refer to? I'm just messing with you.
The viewers want to know.
Yeah, the viewers know. If you don't know, don't ask.
Don't ask, don't tell. You're oh my god. Oh, you slammed my door shut on me. I can't get out. Oh, is this your original plan to invite me in with an alliance and then trap me? Handcuff me and then stick me full of stone?
Exactly.
Feed me poop for an hour?
That'd
days?
Be really funny.
Yeah. I haven't gotten to the dungeon yet.
Oh wow. You have a lot of metal pieces. So for the viewers out there, like, do you get most of your metal pieces from underwater drops, or do you get them mostly from...
I just got them out of drops.
Like yellow?
Yellow,
red, purple?
And sometimes red. Then in here, this is like the other craft area, dino storage area. So here I've got my cauldrons going, and I'm trying to figure out how to make the chicken and rice. I can't really figure out how to combine them.
So
I cook the rice...
So for the viewers out there, the cauldron is the equivalent of the industrial cooker, just no piping any water in there. You have to use water skins or water jars.
You can still make the cooker.
Go ahead there, Mayo. What's up?
You can still make the cooker.
Yes. Well, you can learn the engram. I thought you can only make it in fabricators.
Yeah,
you
see,
I have
you
one
can.
Of those.
You have
some people have fabricators, yep.
Do you have a blueprint? Like, could I like bum one off you?
Maybe.
We'll talk later.
Maybe you guys can arrange a trade. I don't think he's going to give you the blueprint, but he might make you one. Right?
Oh, yeah. I will take just like one or five.
One or five? I like your dino gate, too. It looks pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
So these dino gates go down pretty quick, though, with the ballista. That's what I've noticed. It's, what do they have, like 6,000? No, these are 12,500.
Yeah, these are a little more durable than
so
regular
probably
ones.
20 ballista shots would probably take one out,
mm-hmm.
I think.
Yeah, I'm actually planning to expand this platform out and put a second dino gate down, just so they have to blow through two.
And
yep.
Did you see the little flags that he has?
I love it. Oh my gosh.
Banner,
it's amazing.
That's the word. I was like, what are those things called?
So now this makes me want to have to get to work and like build something a lot better because I feel a little dwarfed, you know? Things are inverting, you know? Yeah.
All right, so now we're going to go upstairs.
Where's the Lucy? Where's the Lucy?
I'm over here. I'm
wandering. Are you caught up? Are you caught up?
I didn't know where there was stairs.
It's a ladder. That's what we're taking.
Yeah,
okay.
I don't have any stairs in my view, so upstairs is a misnomer.
Oh, I like how you put this, because so you put the organics on the back of a ketz on metal, and
mm-hmm.
then you put the metal spikes in between so that way they can't barrel roll through.
Yep.
The only thing you're missing is a ballista or a cannon or a catapult, which I don't even think, what's the use of a catapult anymore? I think ballista and cannon pretty much out.
Yeah,
out
I mean, the catapult's ammo is real cheap.
But it's so hard to aim.
It's because it makes you want to stab yourself in the face when you use it.
Have you ever tried to aim a catapult before?
I have. You can't even see. You have to go into third person.
That, and you have to have a spotter, I think, right? To be able to tell you if you hit or not.
Pretty much. This is obviously an ablative layer down here. They'll bust in and can't really get anything. So then over here, we've got two garages. And this is also where I hatch eggs.
Okay, and is one incubator enough, really? Because I run four of these guys to do everything.
Yeah, I'm in the process of getting more.
They're tricky solo, though, because the way I do it, and I don't know how you did it solo, but what we do is we get a Ketz, we pick it up, we fly it back to a safe spot, and we have somebody hold it in the Ketz's clutches, and we use a regular bow, not a long bow, not a crossbow, preferably a high quality. I lost my bow along the way, though. I think I died, right? And we just shoot it in the belly and space our shots, and there's this like 50% chance you'll end up killing it before you tame it.
The first one I went after, I killed it because I was using a Mastercraft crossbow.
Yeah, they hit too hard.
They just died.
Well, that's not considered solo Alcrin because we duel it. But the other trick is really, really, really low level one.
Yeah. Well, this one's a high level one, unless you've leveled it up a bunch.
He was level like one. He was like level 115.
Okay, yeah. And then Windlord behind him, I noticed, is level 408.
Mm-hmm. He's level capped.
So he's level capped at 408. What was he wild when you got him? Or
so
was he hatched?
140.
Was he
140 wild?
Okay,
so beautiful.
So he was actually tamed, right? He wasn't bred.
Yep.
Okay.
This is my wild 140 male. I have a 150 male that is down there that I'm still leveling up, and he's almost about to cap out, about another 20 levels. And then I've got a female that was 145 wild, and she's also level capped.
So my question for you is, how do you level these things so quickly? Do you kill alphas? How do you do it? Do you craft?
Yeah, alphas. The center area is just usually crawling with alphas. Like sometimes there'll be three or four alphas at a time on this area.
Gotcha. So that's the way to do it. I know that if you have two people in a tribe, you can have one person, you know, ride it.
One person makes narcotics and the other one sits on the dino.
Or make a shit ton of brick walls or concrete foundations or whatever, or ceilings. Ceilings seem to be the cheapest. Like you,
yes,
for
there
it's like
four.
And they give
so
you
here,
and they give you like 40 experience per, which is huge.
This is the loot area. This
Ooh.
Is where people be trying to get to.
So this is where you store all the most valuable shit.
Yep.
What about these? Oh, arrow barrels? Pistol ammo?
I've got ammunition. I keep my ammunition in these barrels.
How many slots, since these are locked and I don't expect you to unlock them?
I think it's
them?
Like 10.
They have 18.
Oh, 18. Okay.
Only 18. I notice you haven't built any of the larger containers. They have the 100 slot ones.
Yeah, they do. I will eventually be swapping over. I'll make the lock boxes and safes, which are they're identical to the vaults from regular Ark, but they're just smaller.
Okay, so I have a question. Why did you choose to put them in barrels when the actual storage boxes have 400 more life?
Well, the barrels have more slots.
Okay, they don't.
Do they?
No.
They have more slots than the small ones. Like
well,
when I
no,
first
the
built
large...
this.
Okay.
Oh yeah, they have less slots than the large storage box, but more than the small one.
But then you should just replace those with these ones, because then they have more life, more durability.
Yeah, I probably will eventually. It was because when I originally built this, I only had it one high, and you couldn't put large storage boxes in a one high area.
Gotcha.
Makes sense.
Ultimately, though, he probably should go for the 100 slotters, I think.
Yeah,
ultimately.
Probably.
Just cut to the chase, right?
Or I'll just make a bunch of the safes, because those hold 150 slots. So now to get to the next level.
All right, is it this way?
We got to jump up here.
Jump up where? Oh, okay, got it. I think. Wait, I lost you. Did you purposely build this super confusing? Because that way people can't raid it very easily? That makes sense. Ooh, this is sick. This is I thought this was a greenhouse from the outside, but I don't think it
That's
is.
That's what the other thing over there is. Yeah, this is my throne room.
You have like an amazing view. Plus, you can see everything from up here.
When it's not cloudy, and it's always cloudy.
Right now it's not cloudy.
Yeah.
So we're getting some amazing footage.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sometimes like this entire area will just be inside the clouds and you can't see anything.
This is insane.
How did you make the banners though?
I did them by hand. So you do one by hand and then you can save the design.
Oh, nice. And
as long as you have the materials to it, you can reproduce it.
Now, are you liking the primitive mod more than some of the other mods we ran? Or what's your opinion?
Yeah, I think this is probably the best mod overall, just because it's so holistic. Now, here is my greenhouse.
Ooh, we got to definitely check that out. I want to see how many narco plots he's got going for those
actually,
fun
my
nights.
My narco plots are downstairs. I've only got one narco plot up here.
Now, are you worried about somebody just flying up with the kets and cannonballing right into this thing? Not that I want to say that on camera, but it could happen.
Eh, not really. I mean, what are you going to steal my fruit?
Yeah, I guess. And you've got irrigation. Now, is this irrigation piped directly into the river below, or is
it? Yep, it's out of the river. The one problem with the river, the rivers down here, you can swim through them, and you can get water by piping it out of it. You can't stand in it and fill your water cups.
Okay, but that's fine. You can just open one of the taps, right, and do it that way.
Yeah, I got all these important things. I don't even know what to do with cabbage yet, but I got some cabbage. And then...
Only two beetles to support all this. So did you end up making bone meal fertilizer to get it all started?
No, just the beetles.
So, quick tip. Now, once you got beetles running, the point is moot.
Yeah.
But literally on that handmill, if you learn the Ingram for bone meal, it's like one keratin, rotten meat, charcoal, hide, and you can grind out fertilizer at the speed of narcotic.
Oh, nice.
Which is way faster.
That'd be good for like expanding.
Yeah, just building out your plots real quick and then maintaining it with beetles.
Mm-hmm.
I love the plants that they made on this. It's like so much more. There's so much to just make in this mod.
Mm-hmm.
Also,
more realistic.
Yeah. Also, they made this an official mod, I think, as far as the Primitive Plus.
Yeah.
Where did Lucy go? She disappeared.
I think she jumped
off.
Come
find me over here.
She is. She's on my other greenhouse area.
You jumped down? Oh, did you jump into the water?
No, I jumped to the ledge right there. Then I jumped over up the.
Oh my god! I took fall damage and I shouldn't have. I landed in the water. I thought maybe I landed on the door frame.
Yeah, the water is not deep enough in some places. You'll take fall damage.
And if you're not careful, you can just like swim right off the side of this into the nothingness.
Yeah, you got to be careful about that.
All right, so how do I get up to where you're at? Let's see.
Here, I'll open some doors for you. Go into the beetle room.
This is my favorite greenhouse.
I see Princess Banana Hammock, and I see Duke Hut. No fapping. Okay.
Up the, you gotta come in here and then you gotta up the ladder.
So yeah, you're doing the ladder thing, so it makes it hard. You have to grapple to get up, right? Is that the idea?
Yep.
Oh no! I fell down again. My bad.
I'm playing in the water.
I'm trying to hit the record button and climb at the same time, and that takes skills.
Yeah, this was the first area that I had some plants growing. So it wasn't really organized or anything.
But, I love it.
So then
it's so
I figured out that you could actually, if you put just a roof of greenhouse, you can actually get the full 300% greenhouse effect without fully enclosing it.
I guess that's cheaper, right? That's what's nice. It's because it's not like the glass walls are going to provide that much defense, right?
Yeah, they're fairly squishy. I think they're like the same durability as wood.
It's like 100 hit points each, I think, per wall.
Exactly. Yeah. It's pretty lame.
You just take a pick to it and two hits, it's gone.
Mm-hmm.
So why probably have a wall,
one,
right?
Probably one on this server since you can have 800%+ melee.
So yeah, and this is where you grow all the other plantsies.
Mm-hmm. And then down here I got more.
Ooh.
These are my narco plots. Some of my narco plots.
It looks all high tech, like you built a futuristic space-age solar panel greenhouse.
Yeah, kind of. Yeah, I've got a lot of wheat and a lot of barley going because I want to get mass-producing beer.
There you go.
And I need to plant more grapes because they grow so slow. They don't produce very much.
Do you plan guests? Do you plan to have guests over and to get, you know, a drink with?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
I noticed that you like Game of Thrones, so do you plan on sabotaging and killing people as they're enjoying their wine?
Maybe.
Like a red wedding or something, right?
Mm-hmm, something like that.
I keep losing you guys.
Invite everyone upstairs. There you are. Invite everyone upstairs to the throne room, give them some beer, and then, like, knock them all out.
Poison the beer?
Oh, if only you could do that. So, well, yeah, that's pretty much the base. They do have a Rex pen down below. We could do some exploring of this center area. It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Show you all the nooks and crannies.
I remember working so hard.
You stole my bird.
Do I have black talent?
You did.
I do. They're the same pretty much stat-wise. Just grab brown. They're both 120s, like back when 120 was hot.
Yep.
And then all of a sudden the 150 cap went up, and then...
Uh-huh. So yeah, down here is my little hokey Rex pen.
So what are the plans for this other than just holding Rexes?
I'll probably build a proper pen eventually somewhere else, like bigger one, more official, something square. But this is just where I'm keeping it. And I got a woolly rhino.
You have very little organic turrets over here. Like, doesn't that scare you?
Yeah, it's just more just to keep people from annoying it. And the Rexes are all on neutral, so they can defend themselves.
Gotcha.
But yeah, it's not as secure as it should be.
Yeah, especially because we know Plurberry likes to come in and sub. They like to come and destroy things.
Speaking of which, Plurberry has been building a base. It's growing.
Mm.
I don't know if you've seen it yet.
I don't think I have. Like, I saw him, like, running around on a bear once, and that's it. So then, this whole area is, like, honeycombed with caves. So down here...
This is cool!
This goes down even deeper.
In your opinion, do you think this is the best map? Like, of
yeah.
the maps that are available?
This is definitely the best map. It's much larger than the regular map, which is too small. And then, it's not as big as Valhalla, but Valhalla has a lot of empty space. So down here, I got a little beaver pond.
Is this where you keep all your beavers on reserve whenever they're needed?
Yep, and this is actually where I get my cementing paste.
Oh,
yeah.
Definitely, that's where we get it too.
Because I just go down here when I need cementing paste, I'll loot all the dams and then break them.
Yep, and they'll respawn.
Yep.
And then they'll eventually fill up again?
You don't need to break them, you actually just have to do
empty
O
them.
And empty them completely out, and you don't have to break them at all.
Oh, really?
Yep.
So easier just to smack it with my bird.
Oh, see, to me it's just so easy to do. Like, it takes like a split second. And
mm-hmm.
I usually come back with about 4,000 after just like 15 minutes of doing it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you don't need as much cement paste on this mod as you do on regular, so you don't need as much.
I have a whole chest full. Unless you have the metal blueprints, then you need more of it, right?
Right. So then this just goes down here to the outer area. And there's just always tons of dinos down here. A lot of Argents, a lot of high-level Argents. I've accidentally killed so many 150 Argents, it's kind of crazy.
What?
He's just going around leveling up and then... Oh man, kill
one. You don't have a breeding pair yet, right? Like, we got two.
I don't have a breeding pair of 150s.
We have
a 150 and a 145.
I think we got a breeding pair of 150 Arges and then a breeding pair of 150 Rexes. And Pteranodons, we had trouble getting a female, but we ended up breeding into a female using a 145.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I have a 150 Pterodon and a 120 who was max. I tamed him when it was the max.
Yeah.
That was actually the first dino I got.
Yeah, I remember were you telling me about it, how
yep.
was just taunting you?
Yeah.
You just didn't have the tech, and did you have, were Bolas out yet?
Yeah, you told me about Bolas, so I used a Bola on it.
Which is just makes it super easy, right?
Yeah. So then this just goes back up top. And then this is all come up here.
We lost Lucy, I think.
This goes underneath the waterfall.
Gotcha. Plus you have like infinite metal available in crystal.
Yeah, there's a lot of metal in crystal real close by. You can just fly over and pick it up. So yeah, that's the center area.
All right. Well, I think
we love it.
I think this concludes the episode. Is there anything else you guys want to say before we say our pieces and all that good stuff?
Mm-hmm.
Are you good there, Lucy?
Come and play on the server. It's fun.
Definitely. The server's been growing. Lots of PvP action. We have a good group of peeps. I've been enjoying it a lot.
Absolutely. And please remember, like, sub, and come over and play with us.
Oh my god. Peace out.
All right. Peace.